In this video, I am going to provide you with three things. One will be the wall framing for the home addition. The second will be the interior remodeling. And the third will be the building plans. They will be at the end of the video or in the last section of the video. And this will just basically be the floor plan, roof plan, and the elevations. And for my regular viewers, I am going to do something different. I'm always trying to teach using a different variety of methods to see if I can make sense out of some of this stuff. And this is going to be one of them. I'm going to use this box here to represent the inside of the building. So the outside of the box is going to represent the outside of the face of the wall framing studs or the wall framing. And the top here will represent the ceiling to give you an idea of some of the stuff that we're going to need to remove so that we can add the home addition on. So one of the things you're going to need to do will be to cut the existing fascia board and roof framing tails or the trusses at the overhang, and you will also need to remove these blocks. And of course, you will need to cut the other side of the fascia board also. So in order to do that, you're going to need to level up here vertically or create a plumb mark on the fascia board and then go away from the building a desired amount. And of course, this will depend upon whether you're going to put wall sheathing on, how thick the wall sheathing is, or how thick the exterior surface is going to be, like stucco or siding. And since we're going to be putting lap siding on, I'm going to come an inch away from the face of the wall framing so that I can draw a line and then cut the fascia board. And of course, I will do the same thing on the other side. And there's a good chance this is going to need to be done before and not after you frame your walls. Otherwise, some of this stuff is going to be in your way. So let's go ahead and remove all of the stuff we need to remove. Like I said, we're going to cut the rafter tails off. And then, of course, we will install some new blocks in the roof framing video. And you can see here where the fascia board has been cut. And we got a nice view of everything after the demo. And the next step will be to frame the walls. We will have 3 outside walls and a couple of closet walls. So a total of 5 walls there, along with cutting some wall framing studs to fill in this window here so that it can be drywalled on both sides. And of course, we will need a new door for the entry into the room, along with a closet. And the dimensions for the closet will be on the floor plan, along with the other dimensions. And we took this window here and centered it in between the outside walls and not the inside walls. And that could be something that you could change if you didn't like that. So that would be something that would look better from the outside than the inside. And our wall framing studs are 92 1/4 inch tall and will create an 8-foot tall ceiling, or about an 8-foot tall ceiling. And let's not forget that your local building department might require a window for ventilation and for a fire escape. And if that's the case, you're going to need to have at least a 20-inch by 20-inch opening, I believe, in the clear so that somebody can jump out of this window if there is a fire burning inside of the building. And next up, let's go ahead and remove the roof so we can get a different view of the interior and the exterior wall here. And you can see here where the wall on this side is a little smaller than the wall on this side because the window isn't centered in the room. And here's a view of our new door, and we're also going to have to frame another wall so that we can install a door going into this room here. And another thing I need to point out is that you will probably need to remove the door here. You can leave the trim or remove some of the trim and then recreate it to where you have an opening without the door. Otherwise, the door is going to be about here, and to come into this room, you might actually need to shut this door, to get into the room. Not going to be a good thing. And next up, let's go ahead and take a look at the new window that is actually centered in between the interior wall framing to create equal sides on each side of the window on the inside. And again, this window could be moved to either side if it needed to be for whatever reasons. And this finishes up our wall framing. Next up will be the building plans. Let's go ahead and pull up our floor plan here. And of course, here you can see where the building is 12 foot by 16 foot wide here with the window centered. And of course, that is not going to be the problem over here. When we install our new window, we're going to have walls with the same size on both sides. And of course, like I mentioned, the door here, if we leave this door on, you can see where it's going to be a problem for anyone entering or exiting out of the room here. So there's a good chance you're going to need to take this one off, or maybe put some saloon doors in here where you can go in and out like the old bar scenes from the old Western movies. And that would be another design idea I will leave up to you. And of course, the closet here, we have an 8'3" on the inside by 2 foot and a 6'0" sliding door. So not much to this one here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the roof plan, where we are going to have a gable roof on this side and a ridge that is going to be a little taller than the existing ridge. And the reason for that is because the outside measurements for this section of the building is going to be a little smaller, 14 foot. Than the measurement over here. And of course, we will have a hip on this side and a valley on this side. And of course, this is what the exterior of the building will look like. The roof will come over here. And this is what I was talking about when I said the ridge here is going to be a little higher than the ridge over here. And of course, we're going to have a hip over here and a valley over here. And of course, our new bedroom window and the window here that is centered on the outside instead of on the inside to provide us with a nicer view on the outside. Next up, let's go ahead and remove the ceiling and the roof to get a different view here, along with what it would look like to have the wall on this side a little smaller and a little larger, the closet, the door here, and of course the door coming into the other room, and the new window, hope I'm not driving anybody crazy here, the new window centered in here where the walls would be the same on each side, the length. And of course, let's go ahead and take a look at the problem that we would have here with the door coming into the hallway if we didn't remove it. So that problem sure seems obvious there. You can see what it looks like. And that is the end of this video. The next video will be on the roof framing. And I will put a link to all of the videos at the end of the video to the next one when I'm all done making all the videos I'm going to make for this one here. I will put together a playlist, and that playlist will either be available at the website or on each one of these videos. And if for some reason I forget to put the playlist link on there, leave a comment, let me know, and I will fix it as soon as possible.